Sorry, who are you?
She's my girlfriend, and she's...
I need my emotional support squishmallow to keep me sane right now. Hello, munchkins. Magandang umaga or magandang gabi, depending on what time you're watching this video. My name is Monica, and welcome to my channel. So today we are watching episode 4 of season 2 of The Summer I Turned Pretty. If you didn't already know, I have made videos on those first 3 episodes, and I've also made a playlist, which I put above right now. But the end of episode 3 ended with something pretty dire. Conrad had a heart attack or a panic attack or something. He's collapsed on the beach, and thank God Steven is there because he would have been by himself and people would be watching the movie. So today we've got a lot to unpack, it seems. Now, if you're already a subscriber of mine, you will know that I try to theme my outfits based on what I'm watching in my videos. And for this series, we've just been going for something cute and pretty and girly. But today is also a very special day. It is Barbenheimer Day. So today we've specifically gone for something pink. This is not the pink outfit I'm going to be wearing for watching Barbie. I'm going to watch that on Sunday, and I'm so freaking excited for it. I've got something else ready for that. I've had that ready for weeks now. And of course, I will be posting that on Instagram this weekend if you guys wanted to see what outfit I decided on. And also, we've got a little special guest for today's video. I've got my first ever squishmallow. One of my best friends bought this for me for my birthday, and I freaking love it. It's so cute and so soft. I've decided to name her Bubbles. Not imaginative at all, but bubble tea, bubbles, and I think Bubbles is a cute name. But without further ado, let's just get on with this video. All right, so episode 4 is called Love Game. Okay, well, Conrad's clearly okay because it's him in the picture. I didn't think he would die, but I am quite concerned about what the hell is going on with him.
What happened?
Panic attack. I'm fine.
It is a panic attack.
Is there anything I can do?
Talk about anything.
Yeah, just distract him.
Yo, the first time you guys brought me here to surf, man, I was so freaked out. I thought you were the coolest person in the world.
I guess you were wrong about that one. No.
I like this. I like how we're focusing a bit more on Steven's relationship with the brothers.
Found out I got into Stanford.
Oh, but it's a good thing.
Honey, this is a good thing.
Yeah.
Oh, you've been dreaming about Stanford since
you were 10 years old. Yeah, but things are just starting to get better with Jer, and he's going to Finch in the fall, which is close to Brown.
You don't have to decide this second or anything, okay?
Smelled muffins.
You want one?
Yeah, sure.
Those are for the open house.
She can't just have one?
You didn't tell me she was here, too.
It's they, not she. This is hard for her, too.
Really? Seems like she's doing this all pretty fucking easily.
If she needs the money that bad, can she, like, rent out the rooms when it's not summer? Or does she just want to get rid of it to get rid of the memories of the sister? I don't understand.
I know my mom's gone, but here she's not. She picked out everything in this house. She planted every flower.
It'd cost tens of thousands of dollars to maintain a year. Money that I don't have.
And they're fucking comfortable, okay?
Why are you whispering right now?
It's Laurel.
Is that Taylor?
Laurel? Your own mother?
It is.
Call your own mother by her name?
I mean, I don't even think she's showered since the breakup.
Okay, well.
All right, they're flirty.
You know, Julia actually decided to cancel.
Sorry, who are you?
She's my girlfriend, and she's...
I'm just doing my job.
Well, consider this an unexpected day off.
Ignore them.
She's like, that gave me flutters when he called her his girlfriend still.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to call you my girlfriend.
It's okay.
Don't worry about it. It's cool.
Well, it's not okay, but it's kind of, it's like, I'm okay with it, but the pain is still there.
Aunt Julia said the AC is broken.
Oh, what? Mm-hmm. No way.
Today's open house has been canceled.
Oh, no.
It's actually kind of nice. To hang out with Skye. It's just me, my dad, and Conrad now.
Oh, where your family do?
Oh. Oh, this is the carnival? This bit was in the trailer where she's like, she looks over and she's like looking at Jeremiah. Also, I know in my previous videos I kept calling him Jeremy. I think I just made that up. I thought they called him Jeremy, or Jeremiah. I don't think they called him Jeremy once. I think I made that up, so. Sorry.
I want some ice cream. Nature's air conditioning.
You can play the games, but we start at the arcade because it is hot as balls out here.
I love how they're filming on a day that's like not sunny. It must just be like really humid, but like they're complaining about the heat and it's not sunny at all. Then again, I can't say anything. When I was in the Philippines earlier this year, my mom and I went out to sunbathe and we were like, oh, it's cloudy. We're not going to get any tan. And we burnt. We burnt through the clouds. Because we were like, we're not going to wear sunscreen because the clouds are out. Like, it's covering all the sun. And we burnt anyway. My mom and I, we don't burn that often. Here we go. So it's like laser tag. I've never played laser tag, you know. I've heard it's fun. Paintballing is something that's never appealed to me because I've heard it gives you so many bruises and I bruise like a peach. But laser tag looks really fun. I'm kind of obsessed with this. Oh, it's gonna be Steven and Taylor. Wait, so is it like, how many times you hit each other? It's not like you're shot and then you're out, okay.
Come out wherever you are.
Boom. Oh, it's gonna be the trio, the little triangle here. Or is it just gonna be her and Conrad?
No!
get her!
Beach house is pretty cool. Would have been nice to spend some time there.
With you guys.
Never actually seen anyone reading one of Mom's books before.
I know, me either.
Oh, she sent her a picture.
But if you take a picture and send it to her, she'll find out where we are and come and bust us.
Take a picture and then show it to her afterwards because you're eventually gonna tell her, right?
Mom, Laurel doesn't get nervous.
Laurel, why are you talking about your mom using her name? I don't ever do that. Are they trying to just remind the audience what her name is? Like,
you actually can't do that without a harness.
Cam
Cameron? No way.
Oh my God, the guy that she dated last summer.
Come on, Taylor, you got this in the bag.
Hey, bring it home, Steve-o.
Take it home.
I love the brother just standing there with their arms folded. I don't know what it is.
Yes, sir. I think it might be time. Shoot your shot.
Oh, you're on.
Okay. All right, you two. Their little love thing going on in the background. I see you. Don't worry.
On your marks. Get set.
I love how the Cam Cameron is just there now. He's just like the official judge.
Nice.
This isn't one of those like the fast, like you have a timer and then it's how many hoops you can get within that, or you're just taking turns.
Let's go, baby.
Oh, the no look. Okay. That was, I liked that.
Come on, baby.
Yes, he missed. Yes. Oh, stop. Jeremiah looking at her. I love him so much. I just want him to be happy.
I think you get to pick a prize.
Oh.
The first time I ever had my heart broken was at this boardwalk.
Taylor Swift.
Conrad asked me to go.
Oh.
But he'd come to the boardwalk to see her.
Oh.
I like your shorts.
Thanks.
Yeah, they're really nice.
Oh, girl.
I thought you said they were too short when I wore the exact same ones 2 days ago.
So win me a prize, okay?
Aw, hon. All that you ever wanted
sweet nothings. Angie said this is the best prize they have. I thought you might like it.
Oh.
I'd rather have had the giraffe, but thanks.
He didn't know my heart was breaking.
I mean, didn't he? Like, everyone knew she had a crush on him. He also knew, right? I don't think he did it deliberately. Like, it's not his fault he didn't fancy her at the time, but...
You know what? I'll take the giraffe.
Yeah!
Thank you.
Now she's remembering that exact...
Dancing!
But, like, he must have known, right? I was always under the impression that he always knew she had a crush on him. Correct me if I'm wrong, I haven't read the books, but...
Extremely satisfying watching you wipe the floor with Conrad after everything he put you through.
Just such a coincidence that the AC broke during a heat wave right after the future engineering student arrived.
Right, he did that. I had a feeling because of the way that he reacted. He was like, oh, what? No, not the AC. Oh, gosh, not the AC.
Maybe whichever one of us loses has to ride the Tower of Terror.
Is this the one in the trailer? I think I know who loses now because I think... Is this the one where she's on there with Jer?
He made it so hard not to love him.
Aw, honey.
When he was sweet like this, I remembered why I did.
Did?
Used to love him, I mean.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, sure.
Tower of Terror, because I'm pretty sure that's only gonna end with one of you in tears.
Nope. She's gonna lose, and Jer's gonna offer to go on there with her for support. Bet.
But first, very quickly, let me tell you about my partnership with Fandomian. I have partnered with Fandomian to let you guys know about some amazing Marvel merch they have in store. Now, they do have merch covering many other fandoms as well, but their Marvel items are what have really caught my eye. Their seemingly endless Spider-Man merch is a must-have. It's free shipping to all orders over $49.90, and if you click the various links in my description box and use the code Monica, you will get 10% off your entire order. Thank you, Fandomian, for partnering with me, and be sure to check them out. Their stuff is really cool.
My moves are legendary.
Oh my God, this is
cool. Keep talking way too much.
Fuck me, you're incredible. Come on, I'm trying.
Really? Those are your legendary.
He flopped so bad.
Cleveland.
Hey, it's the writer dude that has a boat and she slept with. That's who he is to me. He has a name. She said it. It's Cleveland, but in my head, he's all the things I listed.
If she sees how big my grief really is, it'll just scare her.
The friends that helped me the most were not the ones who tried to get me out of the hole. It was the friends who climbed down into the hole, sat with me for a bit that really made things better.
I forgot. There was something that I was watching. Oh my gosh, it was Vampire Diaries. Okay, so it was Elena and Jeremy. Maybe that's what I've been thinking of. Jeremy. And she was like apologizing for not being like the responsible older sister that she felt like she had to be after their parents died, because she was also suffering with the grief of their parents' death. And he was like, you know what? I actually felt my most closest to you when we were both struggling through it together. It was actually when you started to get better that I felt my most alone. So he is making points here.
Mark.
Is that a double? Wait, how does that work? Why are there two steering wheels? Just like logistically, the duos are gonna be going slower, right? It's just more weight because there's two people. Is it just me, or are they like not going that fast?
No!
Oh, I think that was Conrad. He was a couple inches. Yeah. Yeah. She lost. She's going on the ride.
No one said you had to do this alone.
So he is. I knew it.
I can keep you company for me too.
Oh. Oh no, absolutely not. Oh, okay, so I went to a fun fair. When I was younger, I went with my friends and everyone went on it and I was so nervous. It was like long, so you had seats at the bottom and then you had seats at the top, and it was like this long, like, not a pole, but I don't know how to describe this. This is not the right word, but I'm gonna just use the word scaffolding. So it's like a long scaffolding in between. There were seats on the bottom where you're like back to back seats. So there was a group of four, two and two. And then at the top end, there was also one. You would just swing all the way around and then the seat would also flip and then you would be flipping. Do you know the ones that I'm talking about? I went on one of those with my friend and afterwards I couldn't move. They had to like take me, like carry me off the seat because I was shaking so much I couldn't feel my legs. And then afterwards I went behind the ride and I cried. I like rides, like roller coasters and stuff, those can be fun, but stuff like this, big no-no for me. So that's crazy though, because was it just her that had to do the punishment? Because it was these three against those three. Great song. So why doesn't Taylor and Sky have to do this too? Stop the way he looks at her.
Jeremiah is always there when I need him. When I was 13, I caught a horrible summer cold.
You ain't slick. I see you. That was just so in our faces. I'm actually reading for the first time The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. Finally, one of my besties lent me her big ass book and I'm reading that in prep for November.
He stayed home with me for the rest of the week.
Stop. They're so cute. Oh, the hand holding. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Okay, damn. No eye contact, broken.
It's just interesting.
It sucks because she might be, I think I said this in one of my previous videos, I think she could be developing more feelings for Jeremiah, but at the end of the day, it's always gonna be Conrad. You know, something was pointed out to me and I think is truly hilarious. All of the flashback, the sweet memories of Belly and Conrad, it's always a Taylor song, a Taylor Swift song. But whenever Jeremiah comes on screen, there's no Taylor for you. That's how you know. It's Belly and Conrad, endgame. Like,
not that I want you two to start things up again.
Oh.
I just noticed there was a vibe.
Oh my gosh, not Steven being team Conrad and Belly, and I bet you Taylor is gonna be team Jeremiah and Belly.
It's just an observation, man.
This is like a little awkward conversation to have. Oh, look at his smile! With like the brother of the girl that you're like in love with. But it's cute. It's nice that like he clearly like has his blessing.
Yeah, stop picturing me in the shower.
Oh, stop! They're so flirty!
How come you didn't want another journeyman?
I'm not 13 years old anymore, Conrad.
But also, why would you want the same stuffed animal twice? What? Everything's cleared out, isn't it? Well, where are they supposed to stay now? Just sit on the floor? The beds are still there, right? This is horrible. Like they said, their mom picked out everything in that place, placed it specifically, and it's all just been cleared out. Oh my god. Go back to small things. I don't be way to end this episode. What the hell? What the hell? Bitch, I don't even know what to say. Like, that's so freaking sad. This is like so many like life changes are happening to these kids right now. They're going off to college. They're also like recovering from like a breakup, some of them. They're suffering through a grief, and now their beloved house is being put on sale, and all of the things, all of the memories inside there have just been cleared away and like wiped out. This is a lot. Like, this is actually a lot. I need my emotional support squishmallow to keep me sane right now. All right, guys, well, let me know how you guys found this episode. We're halfway through now. We've reached the halfway mark, and it's still as sad as ever. But yeah, let me know what you guys thought of this episode. Let me know what you thought of this video. But I think that is it for today's video, guys. If you wanted to hear more from me, my socials are also linked down below. That is my Instagram, my Twitter, my TikTok, and my Letterboxd account. They are all at Monica Catapusan, the same as my YouTube name. I had to like switch the hand so that I would be able to still hold bubbles. On my Letterboxd, I will also be making a brief review of the Barbie movie, which I'm seeing in 2 days. I won't be putting all of my thoughts because I will save it for the video I will eventually be doing when that comes on streaming. But if you wanted my general thoughts, I usually word vomit quite a lot on Twitter. And then I will be putting my general thoughts on my Letterboxd on Sunday. But thank you guys for watching if you stayed until this point. And me and Bubbles will see you guys next time. Bye, munchkins.